In the previous videos, I showed Meshnet features and its use cases at length. However, I haven't fully delved into permissions. So today, I'm going to explain what they mean and how they work. First, a quick reminder about Meshnet. It's a secure way to connect multiple devices directly without a subscription and is absolutely free. Remember that the permissions exist for a reason. They ensure that nobody can access your computer or data without your knowledge. Keep in mind that while you can provide any of your Meshnet connected devices with any permission they support, you can only set them for the devices you're currently using. This means that you can only give other devices access to your machine you're currently using. In other words, you can only adjust permissions for incoming connections. This also means that unless you have direct access to a certain device, the permissions to access it cannot be changed. Currently, there are four sets of permissions: remote access, file sharing, traffic routing, and local network access. Let's analyze remote access permissions first. It is enabled by default for all new devices but can be adjusted at any time in the permissions menu. This permission allows other devices within your Meshnet network to access services or file shares on your machine. This setting helps with remote desktop or game server access. To open a remote machine through Meshnet, you must enable remote access permission for all the devices used as clients. Additionally, due to the way Docker handles its network connections on Linux-based computers, you will need to allow network access permission as well in order to access containerized services with Meshnet. Next, the file sharing permission. This setting is enabled by default, but can be adjusted anytime in the permissions menu. It allows other devices within your Meshnet network to share files. Additionally, certain devices have a separate permission to automatically accept all incoming transfers. If you're looking to share network map drives or folders with other Meshnet peers, you will need to take advantage of the remote access feature instead. The file sharing permission works only with the built-in file sharing feature. Moving on to the traffic routing permission. With this setting enabled, other Meshnet devices can use your computer as a gateway to your local network. This permission is available only for Windows, macOS, and Linux machines. If you choose to route your traffic through another Meshnet peer, you will have the same IP address as your routing endpoint. This permission goes hand in hand with the local network access permission, which we'll discuss in a second. An important thing to keep in mind is that the traffic routing speeds depend greatly on the internet upload and download speeds of the devices you're using. Last but not least, the local network access permission. It allows other Meshnet peers to access devices on your network only while routing their traffic through your PC. This permission comes in especially handy if you want to access devices that don't support Meshnet, such as IP cameras, printers, or other IoT devices. That'll be it for the video. If you have any questions, be sure to let me know in the comment sections below. As always, if you found this video helpful, leave a like and subscribe for more upcoming content.